So we all know how Terraform works. And if you don't, there's some links in the description that will explain it. We write some Terraform config, we do a plan and apply, and it creates resources in the cloud for us. But in this video, I want to tell you about state and remote backends for state. Terraform needs to store its state in order for it to function. I mean, it could just inspect the status of cloud resources every time it runs, but that adds massive amounts of complexity and can also lead to unexpected results. Terraform would have to guess that the object it's acting on is the right one every time. So like I said, instead, it stores its state. This is a mapping of real-world resources to configuration objects, as well as metadata, such as dependency maps, which objects rely on other objects, and so on. Now, when you're working with Terraform on your own, by default, this state is stored in a file on your laptop. But that doesn't work well when you want to collaborate with the rest of your team. Everyone should be working on the same version of the state. So the solution is to use a remote state backend, like a cloud storage bucket. Now, everyone who works on our Terraform code will use the same state. Terraform and cloud storage also support state locking. That means that if one user is currently performing an action that affects the state of resources, the state becomes locked, and no other user can perform actions until the other action is complete and the lock is removed. Let's take a look at a remote state backend in practice. So in my Google Cloud project, I've got a very basic Terraform configuration here, specifying my provider and my local backend. The resource I'm going to create with Terraform is actually a cloud storage bucket, which we'll use for state in a moment. So let's initialize Terraform. We'll run a plan and then an apply. And Terraform creates the resource I've asked it to. Because we're using a local state backend, the state file is stored in my cloud shell. So let's change my Terraform config to use a remote backend. Now I'm using a backend of type GCS for Google Cloud Storage and specifying the bucket that I've just created. I need to reinitialize Terraform and ask it to migrate my state. Terraform will ask me to confirm that I want to copy my existing state to the backend. And now my Terraform config is using the remote backend. And here I can see my state file in my cloud storage bucket. Again, this is so much better for collaboration. Anyone who accesses the Terraform code now, assuming it's in a Git repo that we all share, will be accessing, updating, and modifying this remote state only, not a state file on their own laptop. Now remember, Terraform is idempotent. I should be able to plan and apply again and again without actually creating any changes, unless I've made some changes in my config. But if I run a plan now, you'll see that there's been some drift. And that's basically because when I created this bucket with Terraform, the labels parameter was set to null, and now it wants to update that to an empty object. I can use the Terraform refresh command to reconcile the state Terraform knows about via the state file with the real-world infrastructure. This doesn't actually modify any infrastructure, but it just updates and refreshes the state file. Now, if I run another plan, we'll see that there are no changes to apply. Looking at the state file in our cloud storage bucket again, I can see the labels parameter has been updated. Let's add some more resources to our Terraform config. I'm going to create a VPC network and a VM instance. Once again, I'll run a plan. And an apply. My remote state backend supports locking. That means while these resources are provisioning, we've acquired a lock on the state file. No one else in my team would now be able to perform any modifying actions on these resources while I'm doing this. So as you can see, remote state backends are essential when collaborating on Terraform configs. Thanks for watching, and I hope you now understand Terraform remote backends.